again, friends and fans. Raptor here, and welcome to Transport Fever. It is great to have you here today. So if you love buses, boats, trains, and planes, and automobiles, and everything in between, go ahead and blow up, destroy, and immediately eliminate that like button. Thank you very much for showing your support. And of course, that lets me know that you want to see more of Transport Fever. So if you do, leave your like down below. And also comment down below what your favorite transport vehicles of all time are. Old-timey steam engines, or modern-day super maglev trains, or even planes, or things that may not yet exist, like teleporters. Those are pretty sweet as well. So go ahead and let me know down below. So if you love train fever, you're going to love transport fever. If you loved City Skylines or Sim City or any sort of building game, this is definitely the game for you. Simple tutorials to get you started, a campaign with 14 missions, a free build mode, and access to the Steam Workshop, which, by the way, the game is not released as of this moment, but I must say there's already plenty in the Steam Workshop for you to play with, including modern trains, more modern trains, old-time trains that the game yet didn't include, and all sorts of different transport cars, and all just everything you can think of. If you want a modern-day Mercedes in your city, you got it, man. Plus mini-maps and everything else, different types of mods to adjust the playstyle. It is fantastic. So, without further ado, let's go to the Wild Wild West. Thanks, you guys, for subscribing, showing your support, and everything else. And we're going to be doing a whole review, I think, of all the missions of this game, or at least most of the bigger ones. I've already played through most of the campaigns for the European and American ones, but let's get started in the Wild West.
The Land of Opportunity demonstrates your talent and rise to become the most powerful transport company in the most powerful country in the world.
Power in America. Let's get started, then. We are going to the Wild West, folks, so we're going to go back. Step back with me into the old Wild West with cowboys and Indians and all sorts of bears and lions and tigers and landslides, I think. Were those a thing? I don't know. Anyway, let's get started. Here we go. Into the Wild West. Here we go.
The future lies in the West.
Woo!
We will bring progress to this barren swath of land full of simple-minded country bumpkins and savage natives. But transporting the required goods is painstaking and expensive.
Darn tootin'.
A railroad from east to west, now that would be a real gold mine.
Boy, howdy.
But the competition never sleeps. The Central Pacific Railroad has already started construction on a line from the Pacific.
Not
Let's
those guys.
Let's beat them to it and open up the Wild West.
All right, so we are building ourselves all the way to the west here. And as you can see, there's different medals that you can earn in the game as well for extra challenges. Now, at this moment, there seems to be a little weird glitch with it. In this mission, I've gone through and already kind of completed everything like that, but we should have all the medals already, so it's just kind of a glitch, but we're gonna earn them all over again. So let's get started. Here we go.
Welcome to the Wild West.
Woo!
It is the year 1864, and we
Yeehaw!
Find ourselves in the tranquil settlement of Cheyenne.
Okay.
Somewhere in the middle of nowhere. The tracks from the east end here. Our job, to construct a railroad line to the west. The first transcontinental railroad in the whole of America.
America!
The investors have given us a rather modest sum of money, but that'll have to do if we don't want to scare them off. If the competition carries on working at the current pace, they're expected to reach the goal before us. Let's spare ourselves this disgrace and get started.
All right, let's do it. Okay, so we're building the transcontinental railroad, so let's see what we got to do first, then.
If we want to beat the competition to the goal, we'll need more workers, and workers need feeding. Once the men are half full, this business with food could generate some extra income for us.
It's a good point. All right, we do have a grain storage area here, and we have a little farm over there as well. So obviously our first goal then is to deliver grain 0 out of 4 from the Cheyenne farm to the grain storage center here. So first and foremost in this game, you want to build yourself depots, whether you're building vehicle depots or tram depots or train depots, whatever it happens to be, they must have a depot. But unfortunately, sometimes you can't connect them. So if you type N is in Nathan or M is in Michael, you can rotate. And it's really cool that you can actually build some of them at angles too. So we're going to go ahead and put our first depot here, and it looks really high tech and everything like that. But unfortunately, it is only 1864, so we've got to have ourselves a good old fashioned horse wagon. So let's go ahead and buy 6 of these bad boys. We're going to buy ourselves 6 horse buggies here, and let's go ahead and set them up. But before we do this, we've got to set up a line. So this button down here, we're going to go ahead and build ourselves a new line, and we're going to connect the grain farm to the... What? Why can't we connect the grain farm to the storage facility? Well, that's because you have to build some depots. So if you go ahead and click this, and I don't mean road depots, I should say truck stations. These are where they'll be able to pick up cargo and drop it off as well. And of course, you can do you can have that for passengers or for cargo. But in this case, obviously grain is just some cargo, so we're going to connect both 1 and 2 terminals together, or stations here. Truck station 1 and 2 are now on the map, so all we got to do is connect these on our lines. So obviously first, I didn't need to build a new line. Let's go ahead and add stations here. One here at Cheyenne North and one here at Upper Cheyenne. So let's go ahead and rename our line 2. If we click here, we can go ahead and hit the backspace button and let's name this. Let's call it Cheyenne Farm. C-H-E-Y-E-N-N-E Farms. Perfect. So we know this line and we can easily assign it. And that's what we're looking for here is Cheyenne Farms. So all horse and buggies are going. Here we go. Calling all cars. There we go. Look at them coming and going. There they go. Goodbye. All right. So they'll go both ways, even though, you know, it's indicated that they stop here first at Cheyenne North. They're going to basically split up and go either direction. So that way I think it thins out their, you know, their line a little bit better on production. So anyway, we got to wait for the farmers then to do their harvest. So that way things can be delivered here to the depot. And then once they're delivered to the depot there, they can then be transferred over here to the grain storage area. So we only got to deliver 4. So in the meantime, let's take a look at America. It's so beautiful. Isn't it nice? So we've got a beautiful mountain pass here. We know we're going to be connecting rail line through. So that's going to be the perfect area to connect through right here to go further west. Over here, we've got ourselves a river, which we can cross and get into Laramie. We've got to connect all these cities together. And I do see down here that there's a little tool manufacturing area, Laramie Tool Factory. So all that needs in order to work is some iron. Wait a minute. What was that? Oh, it looks like we've got some Native people here, some Native Americans down here. Looks like they've set up camp and they're just, well, literally camping out. So we'll probably run into them eventually and pass through and say hello. Next thing is to connect to the cities over here of Rawlins and Evanston and Ogden over here, and finally to connect to the railroads of the west over here to get to California, Oregon, Washington, all those other cities and states and provinces. I don't even think they were states at the time. So anyway, we'll help everyone get over there eventually, but first things first, we've got to deliver all that grain, and it looks like the farmers finally started to basically stock up now, so we're starting to deliver that. So this should be a good amount of vehicles to transport that, so there's a constant supply to the city. And once they get delivered here, the grain storage will then basically distribute the grains to bakers and individual homes, so that way they can make their own bread and everyone can have a good time.
Let construction begin. In order not to fritter away our meager starting capital already on the first leg of the journey, it'd be sensible to choose a route that avoids costly blasting operations to build tunnels.
Right, so obviously, rather than going through tunnels, we're going to try to stick to as flat a ground as we can. So if we click on this tool here, the contour line tool, we can pretty much see everything with a giant black line through it is probably something we don't want to go near. So let's go ahead and stay on flat ground. And luckily in this game, we just got to build ourselves a long, straight railroad. And very easy too, by the way, since we're in the American West, it doesn't get too hilly at all. Look at how flat our railroad is. It literally is just a flat floor for us to build on. All right, so in this game too, by the way, you can see the mile per hour indicators, but a lot of our vehicles here, a lot of our trains, not even going to get up over like 30 miles an hour, so we don't even need to worry about that. So we'll make some beautiful turns here. Let's kind of maybe get a little closer to the road here and see if we can hug that, and then we'll eventually cross. I think we'll cross to the other side of the road, and before we go any further here, I'm going to go ahead and build a train station in the town of Laramie, so that way we can connect already. So let's go ahead and all we got to do then is connect two lines rather than plan our route into the city. That'll make it a lot easier. So two different types of stations we can build: train station and also the terminal station, which obviously this one's more of an end of the line or to connect to the main line, and the train station is more for when you're passing through. So let's try to save as much money as possible and build as small of train stations as we can as well. We don't have a lot of cash, we don't have a lot of time, so let's go ahead and try to save as much money as we can. So there, that one's done here. Let's go ahead and get our train line all the way down to, let's just say, the edge of the forest and build. Let's go on to the other side, because we have to connect over to that other side of the river. So let's go ahead and build our crossing here. Ooh, doesn't look like they're too happy with us now. Let's try to at least keep it up over 35, and that's going to be 27. There we go. That should be pretty good right there. 35 there. Let's try not to go any lower than that for speed. Actually, let's do this first. Let's connect across. Let's build something across the bridge, a bridge across the river first, and then we can connect to that a little bit later. All right, let's get close, and there we go. All right, so now we're going to try to connect to both sides of the river. Very good. A very nice looking bridge, too. And we'll keep it wood, so that way we can afford it. And let's try to... Wow, it's already 100-something thousand, but it's the only way across for trains. So there we go. All right, we built ourselves a pretty gorgeous looking bridge, I must say. I really like how that looks. Very nice. All right, now it's very easy. From here, all we got to do is connect the station. And we just need to connect the rail line from here to here. Perfect. And let's see, our slowest speed is 29, and that's pretty good, because I don't even think our fastest train can go over 31.
Wonderful. This one leg completed already. However, we're already encountering our first difficulties.
Yeah, there they are.
It's very good of the government to place this land at our disposal free of charge. If it weren't for those damned Indians. They've pitched
their
tents right in the middle of our planned route.
That's
fine. Our scouts seem to think they're rather displeased with the white man and his iron horse, and that's us.
Well, all right, let's see what we can do to possibly negotiate with these native people.
Those damned Indians. They're sabotaging our work and are said to have physically attacked some of our men.
Oh, no.
We need to do something. We have various options. Either we buy them a piece of land of equivalent value, which could get pretty costly, or we could settle it the old-fashioned way, which would probably cost us our good reputation in certain circles. Or else we could try to bribe them with firewater, although its consumption is known to make one rather aggressive.
Well, I wish 1v1ing in men of war could be a good option, but I think from here we'll take the more political route of buying and exchanging land to see if perhaps we can, persuade them to go elsewhere. It looks like we did. Hey, all right, cool. Oh, well, that's nice. They're still here. We don't have to really necessarily ask them to leave. We'll just build right between their tents. That's cool. We can just wave at them from the train cars. I'm fine with that. All right, let's slow down time a little bit here. I was going at high speed, but we definitely didn't need to do that. But we did make some money, though, to pay for our train route from delivering all that grain, though barely any. But at least it helps with the construction costs. So now we've got a railroad built between two locations so far. So let's go ahead and connect Laramie and Rollins first before we go any further. And we can already build a train, but I don't want to do that just yet. That's going to cost us some money, and we need all of our money first for our railroad tracks. So let's just squeeze in between the native people here. Let's see if we can go. Actually, let's build our route here first. There we go. We're just passing through. We're cool. We paid off. They're good. We're friends now. All right, and let's go right here to the station. Very easy. Very nice. All right, perfect. Now, let's see. Rollins up here. All we got to do is build ourselves a station. Let's go ahead and build it right here. I already see the perfect spot for it. Right there. Perfect. Wow, they're already building houses in Rollins, too. So it's definitely becoming a busy place. All right, good. Now, let's just connect these two train stations together via our long road. Ooh, boy. That is a long road. There we go. Look at that. 75 the whole time.
The problem with the Indians has been settled, but we've already encountered our next challenge. Ooh. Before us lie miles and miles of nothing but bone-dry steppe.
Yep.
We'll need to make sure we don't run out of water. However, there should be iron ore deposits that we can exploit to earn a bit of extra money and to produce tools.
Ah, very good. All right, we're going to need a lot of extra money, I think, in order to build on this rail station. So here's what we can do. We've got ourselves, as I pointed out before, the Laramie Tool Factory, which seems to just use cast iron or just regular iron in order to do that. And here's the iron ore mine. And in order to produce things, we've got to connect these two together so we can make some money. Blang, blang, y'all. So let's go ahead and just use this railroad track here already. We don't have to connect passengers just yet. Our route's not complete, so people aren't technically going west yet. So let's just use this in the meantime to transport some iron ore back and forth so that way we can get some extra cash. So let's build our station here, and this will connect right directly to the iron ore mine, and then we'll go ahead and connect to it right away as quickly as possible here. There we go, and we'll build a route straight in. We'll just use these tracks for the meantime. And of course, that'll help us to save money because, multiple trains on one track is much more affordable than building a track for every train. All right, let's go ahead and build ourselves another depot. It's a train station. It's very nice, by the way, to build the ends of your line first and then connect them as soon as possible. Let's build this at a little bit of an angle. There we go. And we'll build ourselves a depot as well. We'll need, of course, a depot in order for us to actually put out trains onto the roads. So let's go ahead and connect these two routes up, and we should be good to go. Perfect. All right, let's go ahead and put our train up here. So nice, interesting thing about depots is you need to make sure that they can go either direction. But let's go ahead and put our depot off over this direction. And let's go ahead and build it right here. Let's flip her around. Oh, there we go. This should be perfect. And let's build it right about here. Oh, wait a minute. There's a question mark going on. What's this all about, Rollins?
It is rumored that a huge nugget of gold,
gold?
Is buried somewhere in the wasteland before us. The first settlers are
somewhere
buried it somewhere out in no man's land while on the run from gunslingers. An aging saloon girl in Laramie knows more.
Oh, okay. Let's go see the saloon girl. She's at Laramie. What's up, sweetheart?
The huge nugget is buried in the desert, says the lady in the saloon.
That could be anywhere.
That is, of course, incredibly vague. However, she also seems to think that the Indians might have already found the nugget and then reburied it, as in their minds, gold cannot be eaten.
All right. Unless it's a golden chicken nugget, then that'll be eaten right away.
A small Indian boy who was evidently better disposed towards us than his father's has whispered the following to one of our people. In the mountain that the sun kisses goodnight and where the shadow of the great tree pierces the heavy rock, you will find nothing that can be eaten. What is that supposed to mean?
What? All right, so the Indians, the native people here, have hidden the giant gold nugget, the mysterious gold nugget around here somewhere, so we'll have to find it eventually. But let's get back to our iron ore building. Our iron ore line. Alright, let's go ahead and connect these two sections up. So all we gotta do is swing around here, right? Perfect. And, oh wait, oh, too much curvature. Oh, really? Oh, it looked perfect to me. There we go. And we'll connect this side up in the same manner up here. Let's see. And we should be good, right? An extra 6,000. Are these lines gonna connect perfectly? No, see, you gotta really look at that kind of thing. Sometimes the lines get a little disconnected, miscombobulated. There we go. How are we looking here? Perfect. How's our connection here? Perfect. All right, let's build it. Nice. All right, now we've got ourselves a fully connected line, and we want ourselves a big O train to make as much money off that iron ore as possible. So let's get the general. Now, I'm not talking car insurance, ladies and gentlemen. We're talking about the 440, the general. This American-type mode of locomotive was very successful on many railways in the U.S. and is known from the Buster Keaton film, The General. Why would you call it the general? The film hasn't even been made. What's film? What are pictures? What's clean water? Okay. All right. Those are things that don't exist for sure. All right. Now, in order to transfer this, we need gondola. Yes, this can transport iron ore as far as we need. So let's go ahead and make sure we've got as much of it as possible being transferred. And boy, we just spent a big chunk of our money, but that's why trains are the best and also the most expensive at the same time. Okay, before we get this going, we've of course got to connect two areas. So just like with the buses and everything else, we have to connect Rollins South with our new line to our other area in the south. Well, actually, this would be the east, which is Laramie Siding. So perfect. Our train can take that route, and we can make as much money from it as possible. Perfect. Let's go ahead and do that, and then we can make money from our tools. But where do we sell tools? We can deliver them here to Laramie, possibly. Yes, it looks like some commercial buildings are selling tools. So we can deliver it to Laramie and even possibly have some trains come back to Cheyenne or something with like a car or something like that loaded up every once in a while. But for now, let's get started with what we've got. So we've got our train ready to rock. Let's go ahead and grab that train. Where'd that train go? Here we go. I need you. Train. There we go. And take line. Oh, crap. Is it line one? Line one. Train on line one. All right, there we go. What's that other line about? Was that the one I accidentally made for no reason? Let's go ahead and just delete that because I made it by mistake. Easy. So a nice thing you can do, by the way, is if you want to cancel a line and sell all the vehicles, you just click that. All the vehicles will return to the depot. So if you want to update a bunch of horse and buggies to finally a combustible engine, then you can definitely do that. Obviously switching from horses to combustion engine going to be more reliable, hopefully, and make you much more money. All right, let's flip the train around here. Sometimes it goofs up. What is it doing? Wait, what's wrong? Oh, it doesn't have a route to take? Yeah, take line one. What are you doing? Should be able... No path. You're right on the path. It's right directly on the path. Oh, well, that's a little goofy. All right, let's have him flip around again. Oh, it might be because he's actually on the... he's still on the junction. That's why I didn't technically do that perfectly. There we go. Why can you not go? All right, let's speed it up here. That's weird. So, again, we want to connect there to the iron ore place, but iron ore now that these routes are connected, it still takes time for iron ore to be delivered there. So we've got 376,000, so now we can continue on. Oh, actually, we could try to find the gold nugget. So, the natives told us that they hid it somewhere where the sun says goodnight. So, we're going west. This direction is west. Sun sets in the west. We know that this is north and south, so that wouldn't be it. Let's look for the nearest mountain in the west. Here's a mountain here. We're looking for where a rock and a tree meet. So what, are we looking for a rock growing out of a tree, or a tree like near a rock or something like that? I wonder if we could bulldoze a few rocks or something like that. Well, that actually costs money. Crap. Oh, wow. Well, wait a minute. Oh, right there. That's it. Right there. Is that it? Okay. All right, all we got to do is start looking for this thing. I think, okay, so we want to dig for the gold, lower terrain. So here, so we got our first experiment with the terrain tool. So let's go ahead and look around for this rock. And this gold nugget, if you will. Hello, gold nugget. What the hell? Oh, it's just a sad hole. Look, oh.
Our loan has already been used up.
Well, I was looking for gold.
But if we ask nicely, maybe they'll give us a little bit more.
We found the gold. It's true. We found it. Our treasure. I like how it's like, hey, we're out of money. Hey, we found gold nugget, but we're out of money. Well, yeehaw, partner. Heck yeah. All right, gold nugget is ours, and we've left a beautiful mark. This is big enough for a jacuzzi. Wow. Jeez, I bet they regret that. Look, we just dug a giant hole. You can see that thing from space just to find a gold nugget. And it cost us some money. But the good thing is, at least the train is going to make us some money now. So where's that train on his way? Oh, there he is. Yeah, see, that invalid path thing wasn't right. Otherwise, he wouldn't be returning if that wasn't the case. So now he's going to come back up here. So now they want us to take out a loan. But we don't have to do that because we got options to make money now, folks. So let's speed up time again. And let's continue on our railroad building. Now let's make sure this line is definitely compatible. We've got our train on line one. Line 1 goes from here at the iron ore depot where the actually, another thing we can do too is let's have the train wait for an absolute full load before he's actually going to move. So once he's got a full load of iron ore, then he can depart. Now, in the meantime, let's go ahead and build our railroad a little bit longer, which shouldn't be too much of a difficulty. All right, right here. All right, we got to keep this railroad a-rockin', and we've got to connect to all the green circles this time, which is going to cost us some money. So let's go ahead and... or do we just wait, actually, to be able to distribute those tools and make more money? Let's go ahead and take a look. In fact, let's take a ride on the crazy train. Whoa, here it comes now. Look at this. Absolutely gorgeous in this game. The American landscape, the towns, the cities, you can go through them all on the trains, the trams, the buses, and everything else. So, all right, well, it looks like we just loaded up. We've got a full load. That is beautiful, man. Good timing. So we've now got a full load of iron ore. And we're coming in now to, where are we going? I think it's Laramie. Yes, the Laramie Tool Factory is where we're going to deliver all this iron ore to now. Look at that. That is absolutely... Hold on a second. There. That was worth a Steam screenshot right there. That was absolutely beautiful. That is just wonderful. Like, that's just absolutely gorgeous. And you know what this gets me excited for? Is the next Red Dead. Red Dead 2, man. I'm really excited to see the American West. It's absolutely gorgeous. Still relatively unsettled, even though there's highways and buses and trains and trams and everything else that go around there. Still, it seems like untamed territory and absolutely gorgeous. All right, so now we're going off on our junction again, and we'll be swinging by the depot, I think, off in the distance somewhere. Oh, no, that was behind us. But up here is our transfer station, our terminal, where we're going to drop off that iron ore. Let's see how much money we can make from this. And we made a whopping, all right, $279,000. That's very good. All right, so now we can continue to deliver back and forth between those. So hopefully that'll bring in some more cash for us to be able to build the rest of our rail line. But before we do that, we've probably got some tools sitting here waiting. So let's see if we can build a little rail a little road depot and start distributing our tools. Now, before we go any further, let's slow down time a little bit here. If I could turn back time. All right, let's go ahead and build our road depot here. Let's build it over here. Right in town. Perfect. All right, let's build ourselves a little depot for, what do we want? Cargo depot, which is the truck station. I always just call it the depot, thinking that it's just, you know, where things are gathered. But anyway, truck depot there, and our other truck depot somewhere in here to distribute all these goods to people. And I just want to do it without having to demolish any buildings. If we have to demolish a building, it makes things a heck of a lot more expensive. Let's see where we can build it where it's going to make the most money. Oh, this is actually a very good option right down here. Yeah, that distributes to almost the whole town. Look at this person's getting a new depot right in their backyard. Look at that. Does that house go underground? Okay, that's weird. All right, anyway, let's go ahead and buy ourselves some horse and buggies now to deliver what we want to be tools this time. So let's buy some road vehicles. Let's buy four of them. We don't need too many. We're not going to be getting too many tools, I think. And maybe not too many buyers on that. We're making a new line as well. And let's go new line under road. And let's go ahead and... We can name these as well. I haven't been naming them. But let's add stations. 1 and 2. Perfect. All right, let's go ahead and go with those. And let's call this one the tool line. Nice. All right, so tool line is ready to rock, and let's go ahead and put everyone under the tool line, and we should be able to make some money from that. Now that this route has been connected, oh, I forgot to also put in one extra thing. I want to make sure that the tool line actually waits for a full load at the Laramie Central Station, which is here, before they return to town. Okay, so now, next thing is, now that these routes are connected, now that there's a pathway from the iron ore mine to the tool factory, and from the tool factory to the potential customers of that line, they're now going to, you'll see some tools showing up here very shortly. It will take some time, though, for the line to kind of start making its tools, but they will be here eventually, and we put all of our vehicles on wait for full load. So hopefully they start lining up now, and we'll have everyone ready to go. Now, this will be a constant cost to us, but as soon as the supplies start arriving, we'll be making some more money from that. All right, so our iron ore line should be good. Our train is departing again. There's some more iron ore left behind, so that's perfect. We got a perfect mix there. Now, let's continue on with our train route then, shall we? All right, so let's connect here. All right, we've connected to position one and position two. Where's the third one? Oh, it's gonna go over to the right a little bit. Okay. And it looks like we are out of cash, but we can make our spin this direction. Perfect. Let's keep going as far as we can. And... oh, we're out of cash. Negative 21,000 now. Oh, no. No bueno. All right, well, that's all right. One of our buggies is actually full up with tools. He's leaving. Okay, they're going to make the delivery now at this terminal down here. Here comes through the... look at that. Isn't that cool? The old Wild West. All right, so now we're delivering some tools, so that way things can be made at some... well, these require machines and stuff in order to function, but we can deliver tools to the masses, hammers, nails, everything else. Hardware tools, beautiful. $2,000 made from that. So a little extra cash on what would have normally been thrown away, and a big boost in tools with the delivery of more iron ore, which means more cash for us. Beautiful. That means we can now build our train line even further, so that's a good situation to be in. All right, so let's continue to build our route. Now we've got an extra 200,000, so now we can really build this route. Beautiful, man. All right, let's swing into this next route here. All right, and then what I mean by that is I want to kind of take a left turn because we're passing by the other stop here. Well, let's get ready to swing back the other way now. And I think that's it. Now all we got to do is connect to the town. So we connected to five areas here. Let's connect to Evanston now. And it looks like we actually might have to go through a little bit of a mountain here, or it looks like, well, we can hug the road, we'll be fine. Okay, so I think depots or stations are usually about 80,000 for trains, so unfortunately I don't think we're going to be able to cut it on that one. We'll need to wait until we get a little bit more money, but we can make our train line a little closer, and I think we'll make our station right over here. So we'll get as close as we can. We're rocking through the west here. All right, there we go. Okay, so we got only $532 in the wallet, so I would like to invite you all over for sandwiches. Because, oh, good, we just delivered some more tools, so that brings us up a little bit. Look at that, the train is almost not able to keep up with the supply. That's very good. That means we can either buy another train, or we can have a longer train, some more train cars deliver. That would be just fine, too. All right, we've delivered a lot of tools already, and more to come as well. That's very nice. Oh, look at that. They're continuing to move, so that's good news. All right, we're going to need some more cash, so we're really reliant on this train from coming down here. It's difficult to make more money, though, because, as you know, we've got to continue to make our train line long, so there's expenses that we don't necessarily want, but we definitely need, and not very valuable at the moment to transport passengers. If we started transporting passengers, these cities are so small, and no one's really living here, that there's nobody really to transfer. First, you got to supply them with goods such as machines and such, so they can upgrade their, well, by machines I mean tools, but obviously the more goods you give them, the more people will want to live there because their needs are being supplied, and there you go. Just because there's 1,000 ways to go to a town doesn't mean that 1,000,000 people want to live there. All right, beautiful. More money for us, very good. More tools coming in too. We might need to make this train a little bit longer. Where's this depot? Let's send them back to the depot. Actually, I think those train cars are a little too expensive. I think they're like 200,000 each. So let's stop here. Let's put her on slow mode for a moment, which is normal mode. Let's see how close we can get to our train depot or our terminal. And let's go ahead and build ourselves a nice terminal here. All right, so yet another train station. I know I said terminal, but my terminology is always mixed around, so it doesn't matter. All right, let's build it right here. This should be perfect. All right, about there. Awesome. Okay, so another train station connected, and let's connect these two lines up. Beautiful.
The workers are refusing to lift a finger.
What?
They're claiming that they haven't been paid for months.
Oh, that's
not
true.
No idea whether that's right, but we're pretty short on money, and it's only a matter of time before the investors pull the plug on funding us.
Yeah.
We could put off paying our guys until next month and promise them double wages in return. Or there's another alternative over in Ogden.
All right, let's go look at the Ogden alternative. What's going on over here?
Highest hardworking people live in Ogden, who outright refuse to accept the progress of civilization. They would work for us for almost nothing. In return, we only need to help them build a new bridge so that they can get their harvest across the river to the village.
Oh, really? All we got to do is build a bridge? Okay, let's help them out. Okay, all we got to do is build ourselves a small street across, and we just don't have the funds to pay our workers. It would just it would be a no-go. Alright, looks like we need about 60,000 before we can do that, though. But wait, the workers won't work without it. And why do we just lose a ton of money all of a sudden? Alright, hold on. Well, our railroad will work, but they won't lay any more track. That seems to be what it is. Okay. Well, let's get up to 60,000 then. Our good old train is making its way back. Very good, the general. Alright, let's go ahead and continue to monitor the situation. We've still got our tools being transported into town, right? We're still making money from that. Good. At least it pays for, or at least helps to pay for maintenance costs and everything like that. Same down here at the with the grain. So that's good. Good old grain. Alright, train's coming through. Hopefully we'll make our money there, and then we'll quickly plop down that bridge, because we do not have the cash to pay that at all. And we don't have the time for it. So anyway, we're almost to 1872, by the way, which, remember, 1874, we have till May 1874. And here to build a bridge straight on through, that's going to be 67,000. So hopefully we can hit that mark. Come on, ore train, we need you. Oh, we need even more money now. That's not good. 109,000. Money went up a little bit from our delivery. I'm just watching it down that lower left corner. Come on, baby, come on. Ore train, we need you. Come on. Oh boy, 135. Oh, this is gonna give us barely any. 143 there, we got it.
Good, finally it's back to work. Unfortunately, our tools are worn out and terribly inefficient. Fortunately, we acted with foresight and have already built up a sufficient supply.
Yes, we did. All right, on we go.
The new tools are a blessing. They've made our work much easier. Now quickly over the hill to Ogden. And from there, we're just a stone's throw from our destination.
From
so come
victory.
On, chop, chop.
Chop, chop there, buddy. Okay, not a problem there, guy. All right, so we've got our ore train doing a lot. Now, in order to make it the rest of the way, we need money. And in order to get money, we need to deliver more ore. And to deliver more ore, we need more train cars. And to deliver more train cars, we need money. The point of the thing is we need money. A lot of it. So let's go ahead and continue on then with, well, we only got $10,000 in the bank. That's not good. No bueno. It's not enough for that train to get back and do its thing. All right, so with the remaining money, or with the initial money we get, the continuous money we get, we need to build to Ogden, which is going to be a little bit of a stretch. So let's continue to make money on our ore train. And hopefully if we get enough good cash, we should be able to do this no problem, meaning that we'll be able to upgrade our train soon enough. So let's take a ride on the train again. And we're bringing iron ore from here to Laramie. And I love this route. It's so gorgeous. You can hear the birds chirping. So wonderful. Laramie Sidings is where we're going to right now. And there's a weed. Interesting. And there's a tree. Very interesting. Oh, and a rock if you look over to the left side. Hi, Saddam. Okay, so we've got to get to the depot here. Quick, 80,000 in the hole. Man, it like takes half our money just to get the train down here. By the time it gets back up to the depot, we're out of cash again. So it shows you definitely paying those workers was an absolute no-go. Glad we just built a bridge for 60,000. All right, let's build it. Let's go. Let's get that money. 177,000, beautiful. Unfortunately, we need like 200,000 in order to build to get enough train cars to continue to haul more ore. So we don't have time for that. So let's just build the train, let's build the thing as long as we can. The railroad here. Hold on, seems to be a little bit of an incline here. That's strange. Well, that seems to make it a lot more expensive too. All right, let's go little by little then. Don't really care too much about the elevation. We can still go full bore. This will lower the cost of our building, since we're not digging into the ground. And we're going to hug the road this time. Oop, that was a bad move. Luckily, we got our ore train supporting us. And we can sure as hell make a lot of progress here off just the 100,000 we were given from that delivery. Our ore train is a blessing. And there we go. All right, let's keep getting closer to the destination. And it looks like we're just out of dough again. Just got 1,000 left. All right, so now our ore train should be on its way back to delivery again. Oh, it looks like it's just arriving, actually. But it will have a full load right away. Very nice. Very good. I'm glad we didn't build a longer station. That would have been even more money for us. We built a depot up there, but we do have a depot down here as well that we could have used as well to save some money. Each depot costs... let me tally up the costs here of what we could have saved. Oh, it's 20,000, so not too much. A lot less expensive than I thought it would be. All right, so here we go through the forest again. And then we've got to get through the native lands over here. I'm surprised they actually didn't move. We gave them money to move, and they're still chilling, so that's cool. I mean, that's fine. So long as we got an agreement that we cool, then we cool. That's all it is. All right, come on through, train. Here it comes. Wow, look at it off in the distance. All right, come on, baby. We need that money. There we go. Four full carloads of cargo and more machines being made at the wonderful machine shop, the tool shop here at Laramie. All right, train, come on in. Unload. There we go. That good old money. All right. Ooh. Okay. All right, we're now in 1871. We got to get going quick. All right, we are almost there, though. Let's continue to build. Let's see here. Stay close. There we go. Wow. There we go. All right, perfect. And all we had to do is connect to Ogden. So we're almost there. We need about 80,000 for a depot or a train station. And so let's, we're going to probably build it right here. So let's continue to build as if we were going to our final destination, which is Promissory Summit. Oh, actually, we might have enough now. Hold on. Let's see if we can build our depot. Our train station, as always. All right, we want the short one, right? There we go. 85,000. All right, we need another train delivery. I think we should put it right here, and then we'll just have our train circle in from just behind it, and then we'll cross the road a couple of times up and follow the river. So we should be good. All right, ore train, it all comes down to you. We need money. Now, of course, we could be having passenger trains going as well, but there's absolutely no way we can make money off that. No way whatsoever. Passenger trains, there's just not a lot of passengers out here at all. Wow, $30,000 spent on vehicle maintenance. Jeez, we went from $30,000 to basically dead broke in just a half second. At least we're still delivering grain, but it's not making us any extra money. Grain is not doing so good. Okay, iron ore is going back. And our train's on the way. Relying on this one train is hilarious. And machines should bring us a lot more money than that, too, by the way. Tools, I always keep saying machines, but I do mean tools. But that's all right. We got a good transport network set up to pick up and deliver those. All right, more iron ore on the way. We'll be making some more money here in a second, and then we will complete our Ogdenville. I think I'm thinking of The Simpsons or something. But anyway, we're almost there. Just a little bit further, we'll build our train station here, and then we'll be done with this section, and then we'll just need to make our final stretch to our final destination, which luckily there's already a train station waiting for us, so we're almost done here. There we go. We got the cash we needed. So let's go ahead and connect up. See how quickly we can do this. There we go. 28,000.
We'll soon be done, but we're running out of time. We'll need to make haste if we don't want to become a laughingstock. Quickly across the river and up to Promontory Summit so that everything is ready in time for the opening ceremony.
Absolutely.
If we're lucky, we'll even make it before the competition.
All right, let's continue to make it before the competition then. If we build along this road, it's going to be windy and whatnot. So we're going to build it up to here, and then we're going to go as straight as possible. Unfortunately, we're out of cash again. We need to get our inauguration train running at about 1873, no later. So we're just in 1872, so we've got 1 year to get this done. We've just got a little bit more distance to cover, and we're going to need about, well, if we were to build a straight shot, it's about 137,000, which is about what we get on usual. So we'll make sure that we do this as best as possible. All right, we're almost here. Let's get our road ready to build. Well, let's try to build it a little shorter. That way we won't dig into the mountain as much. All right, right here. Okay, we need our cash. Come on, boys. Where's our money? Where's that darn ore train? Oh, it's just arriving back. Oh, and another vehicle's ready. American horse cart is now unlocked. Even bigger horse cart, I guess. Okay, that's nice. But what we really need is money, okay? Glad we got all these guys to help us with the money over here. We could build depots to connect these two, but it's going to be pennies. We don't need to worry about that. That's just not... We just built a bridge. That's all we needed to do. Come on, boys. Where's that train? All right, so we'll build here, and then a couple more. Actually, we could build... we're going to probably just want to stay on this side of the river. We'll make our bridge closer towards the station up ahead. All right, come on, ore train. Boy, I wish there were more industries we could exploit. And again, that's the bad thing about initial tutorial games, is that you're waiting so long, you know, for because you don't have all the options in the world, and they want you to do something, to learn something. I've learned my lesson. I'm sorry. I'll never do it again. All right, after this load, I think we're going to return our train and sell it off. Because we're not making as much money as we're supposed to. It's taking too long. All right, 279, that's it. Return and sell. That's the end of you. Wow, we just lost a lot more money again. Yeah, we need some good cash here ASAP. No more time wasted. All right, let's go. Let's finish this train's tracks. Here we go. There we go. Okay, so all we need to do then is just build the last stretch and build our bridge, and we're good to go. So as soon as that train is in the depot, we should make almost nearly $1 million from that train. Oh, there we go. He's coming. Man, really just playing it skinny your teeth here in this game. This is supposed to be easy, by the way. I don't know about that. What I really should have did is built two iron ore trains, but then again, we've got a deadline of getting this done before a certain amount of time, so there's a lot of time constraints and stuff like that, and we got to build our train. We're almost in 1873. We got to be done by May. All right, the train's here. Let's stop time. Let's go. Let's do what we got to do. Sell our train off. Where's our train? Oh, we already sold. Good. Perfect. It was an auto thing. Perfect. All right, let's get this done. We gotta buy the biggest and best train we can, which is probably worth billions, so we probably won't be able to buy that. Let's just build the rest of our road here. And across we go.
Good gracious, these pious men are hard-working fellows, but they know nothing at all about structural engineering.
What?
It seems that they were suspicious of the engineers' calculations, as they consider all science to be the work of the devil, as you started building. The bridge has collapsed and needs to be rebuilt. That means additional costs. Shoot.
Well, it is what it is.
We've almost done it. Now we can finally dart across the transcontinental line in style in the first passenger train. We're certain to be greeted by a cheering crowd at every station.
Okay, so our final objective now, to get there before 1874. So let's buy our train here. And let's see, we've got the General here for 317. We wouldn't be able to build a passenger car with that, so we'll buy the more affordable option with a passenger car. Oh, we don't have enough money for that. Let's see. Let's go ahead and sell off the rest of our vehicles then. It's just taking too long to do anything else. So let's get this done. Everyone sell off. Sell off. Sell, sell, sell. All right, that'll make us some money. All right, now what do we need for our passenger car? 272. All right, we're just waiting for the amount of money that we need, 272,000. Oh, come on, boys. Did everyone return? All right, looks like one of our last vehicles here sold itself. Still got a wagon out here returning. Come on, boys. 247. I think we're going to be short because of that damn bridge thing. At least they paid us. We basically did everything we needed to do, money-wise. I think this is the only vehicle under our command. Now, do we have to have a passenger train? Have a passenger train stop in all cities. All right. So I think we need to have some cash for it. I don't know how to make any other money. Has everything sold off? The only way you can make money, I think, is by actually selling vehicles. I wonder if this will count as a passenger train. Now we actually, it probably needs to be loaded with passengers. And we're not making any other cash. So we'll take a hit on that loan. That's fine. Let's buy a decent train then and get across. Very difficult, this mission, for some of the constraints there around the iron ore sections, but definitely a unique challenge. The more you play it, the better you'll get at it, but that's fine. Now we can buy ourselves the actual decent train without being, like, hindered by BS constraints and overpriced cars.
The investors are highly displeased with the wasteful squandering of their resources, as they put it. If only they knew what everything costs.
We're cool. All right, new line, here we go. Yeah, if only they knew everything that, what the costs of everything were, jeez. Yeah, so it's a shame that when we sell things, such as railroad tracks and stuff, we don't get a little money back for it. It actually costs us a tiny portion to actually destroy it. It's like we get the parts back, but we have to pay for labor. All right, so there's the six stops that we need. The only thing we could have done differently is manage the ore train a little bit differently, but still a different and difficult challenge here in this fantastic game. All right, let's continue on. And let's get this done. All we got to do is visit every city before 1874. And the investors, you know what? To be fair, they'll get all their money back. I mean, we've got an iron ore line set up. We've got our first passenger service. We're going to be the first in the nation. There could be a cash prize about this. So they just need to relax. Beautiful, man. What a wonderful train. All right, we're making our way now. Let's go ahead and ride the train then. Let's do our final visit. Across our entire train tracks. Beautiful. So we got to stop at six stations. Did we stop at the first? Yes, we did. All right, that counts. Let's continue. So again, another fantastic game, I think. And definitely one you're going to want to pick up. There's some unique challenge here. I think some of the missions maybe should be modified a little bit. With this one, I would say there's really a lot of constraints on money. Once you do it right the first time, though, it'll probably be easy every time. Though it would have been nice if that gold nugget actually brought us some money rather than cost us some money. Otherwise, there's really no reason to go for it. It hinders your production and your ability to get money. And also, passenger trains, not really worth it until the end because no passengers actually wait too long at the stations. But, of course, I'm sure there are players who are just blowing it away and doing really well. But just as an average Joe review, I'd say it's damn good. I love the missions. Europe is great. The free mode, all good. And I love just riding the train. I mean, to be able to actually ride the rails through, you know, the mountains and stuff, that's a real pleasure. And right now, we're just on the step, very low, and just checking out the mountains. But this should be another one, a GG in the bag. The only one we're not going to get is the loan bonus. And we kind of got boned by those men who didn't want to build the bridge again at the end. So we should have built like a tiny-ass bridge to save money. So the next time that you play this, you'll know that if you go with those workers that the bridge is going to collapse. So just spend as bare minimum amount of money on it as possible. And just basically build it somewhere, the smallest part you can, to try to get some of that money back. I don't think it's a 50-50 random thing. But who knows? Oh, here comes a fountain that we're passing that's hovering above the earth for whatever reason. Wow, the planes are definitely great, aren't they? Wow, the beautiful mountains. We're going all the way to California, Oregon, Washington, other western states. I wonder exactly where we are right now. Cheyenne, I believe. I wonder. Isn't that... Well, actually, like Montana and stuff will have to be settled eventually as well. God, what a beautiful game. This is just really nice to look at the territory like this as you roll along. This should be the true speed of this train. This should just be the normal speed for the price we paid for the damn thing. All right, rolling through the forest here. and we are almost to our destination. Two more stops. We're now at Evanson. And it is February. March, April, May. We've got 3 months to get to our last two locations. Can we do it? Can we get this last goal? I hope so. Two more to go. Glad we bought this faster train. Alright, it's already March. I think we'll get there right on time. Now, that's crazy. That is absolutely insane. So trains don't seem to break down or anything like that. Wow, even with taking out a loan and stuff like that. Man, you gotta be a pro. This is supposed to be the first inaugural mission. Like, it's the first campaign and the first mission, and this is definitely a tight one. There we go. Made a little bit of money from that, but absolutely worthless. I mean, that's about as much as delivering one machine. I think we'll just be just under our goal, unfortunately, of making that one. But still there by... still getting here, though, by 1874, so that's okay. So we've hit all the destinations, despite all the issues and everything like that. I love it. Absolutely love it. But the game makers can make a few tweaks to make things a little bit easier. I like the tricks, by the way, of the different paths of building your train line can bring. You know, obviously the free labor and such, but if I had gone with the... you know, the immediate payment, it would have still been the same issue. We would have still had trouble getting to this last destination, I'm thinking. We would have had less money for a better train, and I'm glad we went with the more expensive one. And there she comes into the station, and that is it for this mission. Very good. So what do we get? 3 medals? Very nice. Very good.
The time has finally come. Yee! The Transcontinental Railroad is complete. This masterpiece will go down in the annals of railroad history. Congratulations.
Wow, it's amazing how it takes a train like 3 months just to go down the rail line. But there you go. Happy investors. We had to take out a loan there. And we didn't beat the competition, but yeah, we'll beat them next time. So until next time, password, Pimpan Strong. I'll see y'all. Goodbye.